So that was not good news and not what I expected. Hey, hey! Welcome back to all my followers and to all you new people. My name is Lindy. I am a mother of four fighting breast cancer since January this year. Sorry. So today, I can't even tell you what my vlog is going to be about this week because I'm actually doing it before I shot it. But today, the plan is I'm going to get my COVID vaccine. I'm nervous. I don't like needles. I'm one of those typical heavily tattooed people who then go, I'm scared of needles. I don't know what it is. I don't know what it is. I think it's because they're putting something into your body, but then ink is going into my body too. So I don't know, but literally the thought of getting any needle makes me sick. I'm not phobic. I just don't like them. I don't mind giving them. But look, we've seen myself give me myself one. Yes? But I guess it is with vaccines is you just don't know what the side effects are. But I'm nervous. I'll get hot flushes before they give it to me. But no, I'm okay. So it's just me today getting my vaccine. Shane's going to get his through work somehow at some stage. And the kids, they will get done when their dad's agrees he's not ready yet. And that's fine. That's fine. I'm happy to just sit off and wait with him. But me, I'm getting immunized. I'm vaccinated before radiation starts, basically, and if I get it today, then technically I should be able to get my second dose at the 6 week mark when I'm supposed to. So I'll see you when I'm in there and warming them all. Hopefully I'm walking the right way. It's completely changed since last time I was here. I was lost, and it's really busy down that end. Normally when you come into this mall, it's you and just one or two others, but I think I'm here. Let's see. Oh yes, I am. There's a big sign right in front of me. And hopefully, there's not been too many. Yeah, there's not. It's empty, thank God. And I'm through. And I've already washed my hands, so there's no wait. Cool. Woo. Oh, there's lots and lots. This is huge. So literally I've just got two people in front of me, that's it. Cool, this is nice and easy. I've been putting this off. It's official. I'm jabbed. We're all jabbed. I'm just waiting the 15 minutes to make sure I don't have a reaction. So that was over and out, in and out, sorry, within, I don't know, half an hour, 40 minutes, allowing for talking to the nurse. Someone's at my front door. Hey. So yeah, Buddha. I'm alive. I haven't crashed. There's like markets going on here tonight. I'm gonna come out now. I don't have my kids tonight, so I'll show you when I come. Yeah, something's gonna be happening in here tonight. I don't know what. And I don't know if this is a regular thing. I swear I've lived in Ipswich my whole entire life. And I have no idea what's happening here. Tupperware. I definitely don't need that. I'm gonna hit. So we're attempting to make our own October awareness shirts. This is Marie and she's going to go print. Let's go.
Here goes. Send.
We've never done t-shirts. Oh, I bought this machine not even a year ago and gave it to Marie because she will use it. And it's not working. That's it. So we got to hope that we got the depth right. And this is for three shirts. Oh, listen to it. I remember that sound. Oh, it's working. Yeah, we're trying it.
Oh, no.
What? I
thought it was too deep.
But it doesn't matter, though, because...
Well, let's hope. Technically, it's not supposed to cut the backing.
It's Murray working on the next section. So when I say I made these shirts, we can clearly see Murray did it. She's doing the tedious part of weeding it. Getting all the letters out.
Right.
So we're going to try.
But if you get in the habit of mirroring every time,
just do it.
Hopefully you won't miss mirror as often when you're
Go.
Your projects. So now I'm going to click continue. And we're going to head to our Explore and cut our pieces.
Eek. Is it wide enough? I'm taking the plastic off. Ooh, delicate.
Oh, I don't know what that is, Linda.
Now we are just doing placement. Oh, it looks so good. Perfect. Yep, I think that's right. Hang on. It looks so good. I'm so excited that we're making this. I think it's even more better that we're making it and didn't buy it.
Stuff off,
and this is me supervising. Poor. It looks so
good.
And then
she
has to flip it over.
Iron on. Use it with your creeping machine. And how to press it in these
I'm different smiling suits. Right now. See, look how clever we are.
Woohoo!
How cool. It looks like it's in the perfect spot.
It literally looks like it's in the right spot,
it does.
Too.
Oh, I've just come outside and have a look at that storm coming. Oh, yeah. Lucky I only live 2 minutes up the road. I thought I'd give a quick fish update. because I haven't shown you my fish in a while, and Sam just pointed out that I have babies. So these are red emperors. These are my South African fish. Let me have a look. And I literally cleaned this tank this morning, so I probably sucked out a whole bunch of babies. But can you see them? I thought those two were looking really red and aggressive. Oops, I didn't mean to suck them all up. And then we've got this tank. Bob's upside down at the back. I don't know what he's doing. And we've put Loki back in here. But Tank is always picking on him, so I really have to find him another home, I think. Maggie and Bruce. And Betty and Jack down that end still trying to breed. They haven't had another successful batch. They've only had the one batch. That's all the fish up to date.
Alright. Oh, boo-boo. So I've decided I'm going to try and get my exercise through virtual reality. So I'm going to play Beat Saber. I've already done 1 5-minute video game. Watch out, boo-boo. Woo! Alright, we're going to restart this game. Definitely, worried mug. Nowhere near as good as I used to be. I can't, the coordination's not as good as I used to be. But I'm still doing it. All right, so now I'm playing gorilla tag. It's basically Red Rover that we used to play in the front yard. But I'm a gorilla. And like I'm literally at this height monkeying along. So let's see how I go. Woo! Hold on, this really hurts my head. But the ground's here and I've got 3 fingers on both hands. Okay. And I really don't know what I'm supposed to do, so roll. I want to go this way. I'm going to roll. Oh, oh shit. Hello? Oh, I've just turned into... What the fuck? Where did these people come from? Whoa. Oh, I've just fallen off a tree. Oh, how cool is this? No one's got these. Okay. Oh my god. How do they run? Whoa. Whoa.
Like only playing for like 15 minutes. That's my exercise for the week.
I just wanted to show what my husband made for dinner. Yum yum. Roast pork over the fire again. I'm so lucky.
Just out with Sarah. And look at this big boy we found.
Oh, they're right there.
I was not looking all the way back for you. We are out. Driving lessons. Oh, looking at plants. Good morning. It is Tuesday and I am off for my, surgical review. So this is with my surgeon who did the double mastectomy. I wasn't fond of him, I'll be honest, at all. So I'm not really keen to see him, but it's part of my thing. I have to do it. I don't even know what he's checking, just making sure everything's okay. I know I've got some scarring under my armpit, but I'm sure he won't give a shit. And then I've got a physio review. Again, I don't really know what for. I think she just wants to check up, make sure everything's okay from the last time she saw me, but I have no idea. But it gets me out of the house. I'm keen to see how well I do at this hill today. Because it's been 4 weeks since I've walked it and I'm feeling like I've got a little bit more energy back this week, so fingers crossed that means I'm going to get up this hill in one hit, but we will see. Alright, see you up there. But I want to tell you what happened last night. So I went out to dinner with my family for my niece's 18th, and when I was signing in at Brothers in Ipswich, I had my hat on, of course, and the lady says to me, she goes, oh, do you wear that for medical reasons? And without even thinking, of course, I've said yes, even though I was wearing this shirt. And then, like, straight away, I was just angry. Like, what the f*** does it matter why I'm wearing this? What does it matter if I'm wearing it for a medical reason, if I'm wearing it for a religious reason, or if I'm wearing it just because I have fucking messy hair? Like, I was just really angry. Like, is it... what does it matter why I wear this hat? And who are you to ask? What, am I not allowed in if I don't wear the hat? I don't know. I wasn't happy, but was not happy at all. Okay, that was my bitch for the day. One go. Well, that hill. I did it. I did it. I did it. Oh, and I can still talk. How good am I? Oh, I made it to the top. So I just waited an hour for my surgical review, and I didn't get it. The doctor's away, so it's a long, long wait. So we're going to do my physio first, and then come back to surgical. It's gonna be a long day. Finally got in and saw the surgeon. My surgeon's away, so I saw a lady and she's lovely. So she just felt my lymph nodes basically and had a good press around on my chest, looking for lumps and just looking for anything really. But she's really happy. She's gonna put on my note that I wanna be referred to plastics. Still don't know what I'm gonna do, but I still want that referral. And yeah, they'll just see me in 6 months. So that's it. Now I go home. Alrighty, so when the doctor came back, she has referred me off for an ultrasound in 5 months, which I'm really, really excited about. So that will ultrasound my whole chest and all my lymph nodes. So I'm really excited that there is some check up on me, other than just blood. So that's exciting. And did I tell you that she's going to refer me to plastics? I think I did. So, yeah, but I'm just excited that I do get that ultrasound in 5 months, because at least that way, if anything's come up, we can get it before I become metastatic. Yay! So I've just gone to feed my fish and I have found Bruce dead. So Bruce is my blue daddy out of Bruce and Maggie, who were there in the corner tank. So he was acting a bit funny yesterday, nothing major. He was just at the top of the tank, which was not like him, but he was still swimming around and normal. But today he's like literally wedged into a rock and he's dead. Unfortunately, where he is wedged is right where Betty and Jack are breeding. So Jack is going ballistic and I just can't get him out because I'm getting attacked. So I have to wait till Shane gets home so that I can get him out. That's really sad. I'm so excited. I have to come on and give you an update. I just got a phone call from my hospital and my gynecologist wants to book me in for the beginning of December for my hysterectomy. So I will go to the private hospital because apparently my hospital is having updates done, and plus they're really busy. So yes, I'm going to go over to the private hospital early December sometime and have my full hysterectomy before I go back to work. I'm so happy. It'll mean, sorry, I'm so excited I can hardly find the words. It means that I am going to have all my treatment completed before I go back to work. Yay! I'm so happy. Yay! That the week has actually been really, really good. I can feel my energy. I actually feel pretty normal at the moment, energy-wise. I was going to go for a walk yesterday, but my toenails look so close to coming off, and I'm just scared, and I'm making excuses as to why I didn't go for a walk yesterday, to be honest. Because I totally could. I got up the hospital hill one go. I was a bit tired after it, but I still got up it in one go. So, but my energy is definitely back. My muscle weakness, that's all gone. That's all just normal now. Sleep is shit. It was shit last night, but I expect that because radiation today. But I've been waking up several times a night, mainly because of hot sweats. Really, I swear if I didn't have hot sweats, I think I'd be able to sleep. Hot flushes, I know, but I call them sweats because I'm sweaty. My neuropathy and my fingers. Look at that middle one. It's just gone black, that one. Yeah, there you go. But to me, they're not feeling as thick as they were feeling. They still look the sort of same, but they definitely are not feeling as thick. But no pain. Oh, there was a little bit of pain the other night, just around more the bases of some of them, where I still feel that some of them might come loose, like that one. Well, they just feel like a wiggly tooth. That one's looking good, though. As for my toes, I'll show you. Hang on. Sorry for my floor. Look, so that's all come off, and it clearly looks like around here is going to come out. And then my other big toe is the same at the bottom, and it's sort of tenderish there and there. So that's my feet, my nail, sorry. Neuropathy is really, really good, especially in my hands. Tiny bit left in this finger. Oh, yeah, tiny bit left in this finger. Definitely this one, but there's no numbness. It's just tingling. As for my feet are fine. It's actually just my toes. And they go from one day I'll have a completely numb toe to the next day I can feel that toe, but I've got pins and needles in other toes. So it changes all the time in my feet. But definitely not bad or anything like that. Definitely capable. So everything symptom-wise is actually, I would say I'm pretty good at the moment. So 5 weeks post-chemo, I'm feeling pretty good. And started radiation, so we'll see how this affects me. I have been moisturizing like there's no tomorrow and trying to stretch. And stretching is literally just stretching. Just trying to open my ribs up. But it's tight. Like she said at physio, I have really good range and all the rest of it. Like good range and good whatever the other thing is. But it is very tight to do. Just because I can do it doesn't mean it's easy. I also, sorry, at my physio, she did that test thing again to test for the lymphedema. And the left arm again was higher, or the right, I don't know which way it works, but it was uneven. But it was last time it was 9, this time it's 7.5, so that's actually better. We're just assuming that that's going to be my normal, that my left will always be different to my right. That's okay. As I said, I am getting an ultrasound. I'm ecstatic about that. Just ecstatic. Because the oncology guy, doctor, he said no, you don't get any scans, you get nothing, you just come and see me and get blood tests. And I've been freaking out. I'm thinking, well, how do you catch localized breast cancer? That means it's going to be metastatic before you even catch it, because as far as he's concerned, if I get pain in my bones or any symptoms, I'll let him know then, and by then it's too late. So this ultrasound at least will pick up any early stage again if I get it. What was the thing I was going to mention? Oh, it's been on my mind a lot lately, about recurrence, and I will need to speak to the doctor next week. Just because I was looking at my results, and I don't know why I'm looking at all this. Maybe because it is, like I said the other day, I don't know what my recurrence rate is, and I need to know. And so I'm looking at my pathology results, and I see on there that I'm not just IDC. I thought I was just 5 centimeter IDC tumor, which is an invasive ductal carcinoma. But when I was reading it, that 5 centimeter IDC was surrounded by and infiltrated by DCIS, which was of a higher grade. So my IDC is a grade 1, which is the slowest growing, but this DCIS apparently is a moderate to high grade, and I didn't even know I had that. So that concerns me, because now that's two different cancers, and that one's faster. And then when I'm looking at it, it also said that in my nodes, one of them was 8 millimeters. Like, that's a huge amount to be in my lymph node, wrong side, but that's it. Like, that's, you know. And then so then, like, my thing is a T2N1. I don't know, ask me what that is. It's some form of coding of theirs, meaning how big your tumor is and where you sit on the cancer scale. And I was looking at some articles, journal articles, and apparently I have the highest recurrence rate, being T2N1. That's locally and metastatic. That's just one journal article I looked at. But then that journal article doesn't take into effect that I am IDC plus DCIS, because I also found a journal article on that, and that one actually said that if you have a combination of the two types of cancers, that from the studies they have done, the duals, which I technically am, have a better survival rate, better, less recurrence rate. But then you always got to look at these studies too, and even if they say you've got a 6% survival rate, these studies were done over 10 years. So say it was done from 2010 to 2020. So by the time the article, the journal article is released, the data's already old, because treatments have changed, and do you know what I mean? So I'm just rambling. But I do need to speak to my doctor, because I need to know what my recurrence rate is, and you know what I mean? Am I going to find it? Because it is on my mind. I think about it all the time lately. I don't know if that's just because I'm becoming to the end of my treatment, that recurrence is like on my mind. And I don't want to live my life thinking about recurrence every day. I don't mind if I think about it every now and again, but I don't want recurrence to be on my mind all the time. I want to live my life. Once I've done this treatment, I just want to live my life. So yeah, I don't know what I'm thinking of acceptable rate is. I'm hoping for maybe a 6%. I don't know if that's asking too much. I think anything above 10% scares the shit out of me. For recurrence, for me personally. I don't know if that's good for other people, but for me, that scares me. I'm sorry. Anyway, that's what's on my mind today. Not just radiation. I'm going to be hopping into. It looks scary. And this is my phone thing that I was telling you about. So my head goes here, and then I have my hands up here. Okay, so I thought I'd give you the full update from radiation. So the doctor saw me. So basically when I had the CT for the radiation mapping, which was not a diagnostic CT, but when they did that CT, they noticed a lymph node right side in about here that lit up on the CT. So this CT, I don't know if you remember, for my followers who have been around from the beginning, I'm not sure if you remember, this actually was picked up on the original CT. It never lit up on the PET scan or anything like that. When I did question it a couple of months ago, they just said that they weren't worried about it and radiation would get it. But because it is still showing up, they are going to be doing targeted radiation specific to that lymph node, like I'm going to have radiation to the whole area, but they are also doing an extra shot of radiation to that spot. So that is a 3mm spot that they can see on my chest, not on my chest wall, but on my lymph node in here. So it's it would make it a third lymph node for me that had cancer in it. They aren't saying that it is cancer or that it's not cancer. They're saying that she said that because chemo did nothing to it, it didn't change it at all. They say that's a good sign. But they will see what radiation does to it. So after radiation, I now will have an actual CT scan to follow this up to see if it changes, anything happens. She said even if it is cancerous, it doesn't change my staging, it doesn't change my prognosis, it doesn't change anything, because 5cm tumor and 3 lymph nodes still is stage 2B. It's just edging me closer and closer to 3A, which I don't want. So that was not good news and not what I expected. But at the same time, that sickness I was feeling today was the same icky that I was feeling on the day that my surgeon told me that I had it in my lymph nodes originally, when I wasn't supposed to find out that day, but it was the same feeling. When I did go and have that CT mapping, in my back of my head, I did think, I wonder if they're going to see anything. If they're going to, you know what I mean? Yeah, so it doesn't change anything as such, other than it's another lymph node that is possibly cancerous. What was I going to say? Can't remember. So yeah, they're just going to treat it and we'll go from there. Oh, I did ask about my recurrence. She can only tell me locally, because that's what radiation deals with locally. With radiation, my recurrence rate is about 5-6%, which is okay. I'm okay with that. Still got to find out what my overall return is, but 5-6%, I'm okay. But she was saying that the hormone blockers that I will be on is actually one of the most important parts of my treatment. So yeah, so not good news, not bad news. It's not good for my head news. But it's just a waiting game from this point. Like I said, it's not going to change my grading or my staging at all. But yeah, so we just have to wait now. So I'll have my 5 weeks of radiation and then I'll go for a CT scan after that. And yeah, we'll know from there whether it was cancer or whether it's not cancer or what they're going to do. Just jumping back in. I forgot to mention, I did ask about the IDC and the DCIS. She said that it is quite common and more common to have the mix of the two, the IDC and the DCIS. She said that it's actually no big deal, and that would be the only reason that they didn't tell me about it. And honestly, they could have told me about it. But generally, it doesn't change the outcomes of anything, she said. But generally, with the DCIS, what it means is DCIS is going to or can become IDC. So, which mine did. And where it said where mine was moderate to high grade, that's different to the grading of the IDC tumour. This grading is more... So if it has a moderate to high grade, which mine has, it basically means it has more chance of becoming, a higher chance of becoming IDC and becoming full-blown cancer. Well, it is already cancer, don't get me wrong, but becoming invasive cancer. So yeah, so that's what that all meant, and it changes nothing as well to anything. And that's why I didn't really know about it. But yep, all good. Okay. So it's the middle of the night and I have finally finished putting this video together. So I thought I would close it out. And I've nearly put together my radiation video as well. So hopefully that won't be too far away. I've got a video dedicated specifically to studying radiation.
Sorry, I'm trying not to wake up Shane. I've noticed today, though, on two of my fingers, you're not going to be able to see it, but the actual fingernail. Oh, I don't know why I try to keep telling you, but it's actually coming away. It's coming away. So I might have to start putting a band-aid on that. Anyway, we are done for the week. Thank you for coming along with me. Please like, comment, subscribe. I'd love for you to join my journey with everyone else. I hope you have had a lovely week. I hope you're all well. Until next time, thank you.
I'ma pick you up in a Cadillac like a gentleman. Bring it glamour back, keep it real to real in the way I feel. I could walk you down the aisle. I wanna do you like Michael.